when you look at the UCLA program, they were like America's basketball team. Sports Illustrated had picked them the team of the century.
The success of the UCLA program perpetuated more success, and players wanted to go to UCLA. And at that time, UCLA became a national television entity.
Throughout the season, sports writers have proclaimed the greatness of the UCLA Bruins. Tonight, before a television audience, they've justified all that's been said about them.
Everybody saw us on TV, and we all became household names throughout the United States.
The Bruins seem almost impossible to stop.
Playing UCLA, that was like playing teenage idols or something like that. They were bigger than life.
Rising out of the unlikeliest of places, the West Coast, UCLA became the standard of the game in the late 1960s. Behind the guiding hand of John Wooden, the Bruins won five of the final six national championships in the decade.
There was a period there in the 60s when I started following the program of just remarkable teams, you know, teams that did not lose, teams that if any other team got within 20 points of them, you thought it was a close game.
Shackleford's 22nd point of the night ends the scoring. Final, UCLA 73, Houston 58.
Wooden won offensively, he won defensively, he won with teams without a great star, he won with teams with three great stars, but he won with all of them.
It was like a machine, you know, and I think everyone can admire a machine that works to perfection.
That's Mike Warren with the long jumper.
We thought we were the best. We knew we were the best. We were the best team at UCLA. We just wanted to get out there and show everybody.
75-72, UCLA.
Under Wooden, the Bruins would have four unblemished seasons, 1964, 67, 72, and 73.
It was not just that he won all those championships, but that he had those long, long streaks of undefeated basketball, 47 games in a row without a loss, 88 games in a row without a loss.
I kept looking for the dynasty to crumble, but it just refused to do so, right down to his last championship.
And they're mobbing Johnny Wooden as he bows out with an NCAA championship.
Walking away with 10 titles in 12 years, Wooden left a heavy burden for his successors. Six coaches later, Jim Herrick brought the Bruins to the Final Four in 1995.
Jim Herrick and UCLA can hang a banner in Westwood.
The media said UCLA finally wins a national championship. So those are the kind of expectations that are with that program and probably always will be.
I've heard oftentimes that it's tougher to stay on top than it is to get there. I think that's a bunch of hooey. Once you get there, it's much easier to stay up around there than it is to get there in the first place.
You'd have a hard time putting them anywhere but right at the top. I don't see how you could rationalize it if they didn't have the best basketball program that this country has ever seen or ever will see.
In Wooden's 27 years in Westwood, UCLA went to the Final Four 12 times and won 10 national championships. Many contend the Bruin dynasty was built on the shoulders of one man, John Wooden. From the Wizard of Westwood to some of our other favorite nicknames in college basketball.